Okay, so the question is, where did the universe come from? And what I've learned in my life is that when there is a question that I can't find an answer to, it's usually because it's the wrong question to be asking in the first place. Meaning that the question in itself contains an assumption that we might not be aware of, and this assumption is wrong. And if the question contains the wrong assumption, you will never be able to find the correct answer. And you're just wasting your time. So this could be one of those questions, because when we ask, where did the universe come from? There is already an assumption in there that it came from somewhere or that it exists. But I'm not entirely sure that either of those assumptions can be made. Rather, I see a possibility that the universe is just another form of consciousness, meaning another level of illusion, an objective illusion versus a subjective illusion of consciousness. So, how did I get this feeling? Well, imagine that you're married or something, and whatever, your spouse, husband or wife, whatever, comes home late, and you ask where you've been, and he or she is like, "Oh, I had to stay up. I had to extra work to do or whatever." And you're like, "What kind of work was it?" "Oh, well, I had this project, blah blah blah." "Oh, really?" And you start asking more questions, and you get more answers, and the more questions you ask, the more answers you get, and it can go on forever. Problem is, just because you keep asking more questions doesn't mean you're getting closer to truth. You're just projecting layers of illusion or lie, meaning, let's say she was sucking some dick or whatever, and she says, "Oh, I stayed up late at work." And with each new inquiry, basically the saying goes, "Ask no questions and I'll tell no lies." And with each new question, you just create an extra level of lie of illusion to shield yourself from the truth that there is nothing there, there is no explanation. So the universe follows exactly the same pattern, unfortunately. It's infinite in all directions. Size, time, it's in size, it's infinite in both, down and up. And just in every direction, it is infinite. It also in terms of layers, meaning we are on Earth, and Earth is part of the solar system. Solar system is part of the galaxy. Galaxy is part of the whatever. There's a cluster, super cluster, the universe, blah blah blah. It's like, and going down, it's the same shit. There's these molecules, atoms, subatomic particles. There's particles in them, etc. And so it's following clearly the same pattern of you ask a question and you uncover a certain level. And you ask a question in that level and you uncover the next level and the next level, the next level, the next level. And it can go on forever. But the pattern itself contains a hint that you are the source of this reality, that it's not that reality existed. And you are discovering it, but rather it's your inquiry that's creating progressively new layers ad infinitum of the illusion to shield you from sort of the emptiness. Now you're probably watching this and thinking, "We know where you're going with this, you fucking asshole. You think that none of us really exist, that we're all just in your head, and therefore this gives you the right to do anything you want and, rape anybody you want, steal from anybody you want." No, that's not what I'm saying at all. I think we all exist equally, even though you suck and I don't, but we all equally exist in the sense that we are all part of the same consciousness of the universe. But collectively, together, we are all still an illusion. Like I said, it's a different level of illusion. It's a level on which is above us, rather than, it's not a barrier that's between me and you, like my consciousness, but it's a barrier that's above us all, and above even all that we perceive as the universe. So it's a barrier that cannot be reached, but we can assume that it exists. So we're still an illusion under this barrier. So, and the only difference is what it's made out of. The barrier of my consciousness is made out of neurons or neural nets, whatever, neurotransmitters, all that crap. So it's subject to, it's something that can be understood through the study of neural networks and artificial intelligence. And the barrier of the universe, the consciousness illusion of universe, consists of math, and it can be understood through math. So that's the only difference. It's that we can use different tools to understand this level of consciousness and the next level of consciousness. And that's all.